Hey folks, welcome to the channel. In today's build, we're gonna do stainless steel. It's been a long time coming, but now I'm anxious to try some of this guy. This is Aeb-l stainless steel. So today's build is really just gonna be a stock removal knife, but it'll be the first time I do a full stainless steel knife. So stay tuned. One of the other things I wanna mention is that the Triple T Tuesday videos, for those of you that subscribe, those are tools, tips, and talk that I've done on Tuesdays. I'm gonna move those videos to Thursday so that I have more space between the build videos that are generally gonna come out on Sundays. So for subscribers, you wanna check out the Triple T Thursday build on Thursday. And if you guys aren't subscribers, why not? Hit that like and subscribe button down in the corner and join me for the next build. But for this one, let's turn this into a knife. So I'm ready to start this build. Got a piece of Aeb-l stainless. Got my template for the thresher. Let's get it marked out and we'll grind it out. I did some research on this Aeb-l steel. I thought it was a newer steel, but it's actually been around for a while. It's actually used for razor blades, so should be pretty sharp. As always, I'm putting in some guidelines so I know how far to take the bevels and how high up the blade I want the bevels to go. Without this, you're really running blind, so you really need marking. Here you're seeing the entire process of me grinding this knife, pre-heat treat. It's sped up, but you're seeing all of it, so it really didn't take very long. Now I'm putting in a sharpening choil. This is a small notch right before the ricasso just to make it easier to sharpen.
I start with a triangular file just to get it started and then switch to a round file. Now I'm just cleaning up the profile around the finger choil and the back spine just to make it all nice before it goes in a heat treat. I started with two pinholes, but I ended up putting in a third. You'll see I have a clamp attached to my drill table. That's just in case the drill bit sticks, tries to spin the blade around, at least it's going to stop at the clamp and not spin around and cut my fingers off. I'm filing out the false edge here with my filing guide. I find this is the best way to do it. For stainless steel, you must have a zero oxygen environment, and that's why we have these stainless steel wrappings, that little pockets that we put the knife in. I'll normalize it in this pocket and also heat treat it. The heat treat for this stainless is at about 1950 degrees Fahrenheit, and then you put it between aluminum plates and blow some air on it, and that heat treats the knife. What you see here is actually dry ice, and I'm cryo-treating the knife just to get some extra hardness. I left it wrapped up like this for a couple of hours. It came out covered in frost. I'm going to go with a combination handle material. It's going to be African black wood and purple heart. And the way I'm going to do it, African black wood, a piece of 15 and 20 nickel steel, a piece of black G10, another piece of nickel, and then the purple heart. And I think it's going to be about there, so about an inch of the African blackwood, and then mostly the purple heart. I know I'm gonna get some crap for not having the guard on my table saw. I just can't cut scales with the guard on. I just can't see them, and it just doesn't work. I like to use this adhesive back sandpaper. I just slap it on my tile here so I can sand off the scales and get them nice and flat for glue up. Now that the handle's all glued up, we're going to take it to the grinder and contour the handles. After this, I use a hand file just to finish it off, and then finally I go to sandpaper and take the handle all the way up to 1,000. Thanks for joining me on this build. I really had a great time building this. The Aeb-l stainless was a pleasure to work with, and I'm sure I'll be doing some more in the future. Folks, if you got something out of this video, please remember to hit that like button and subscribe to get notifications on future builds. We'll see you on the next one.